Templar, 7 Days to Die with Silver Blade.
damn it, son of a... Ouch.
You must remember to wear...
AAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAA
Greetings, minions, survivalists, and fellow gamers. This is Silverblade playing 7 Days to Die, Alpha 14.7, and this is episode 71. And I hope you enjoyed the little bonus that I gave you guys back on Friday, showing off my now fully operational battle station. And as you can see, everything on the outside, touchable by zombies, is steeled up, so they're gonna have a hell of a time trying to get to me. It's not impossible, it's just unlikely. So what I'm going to do now is I went back to the base and made a vault hatch and a vault door. Just gonna kind of flesh out the base just a little bit. Actually, we'll leave that, put that up, and vault hatch. Let's see if we can fit this bad boy on. Let's see which way do the hinges go. Yeah. There we go. So let's see if we could tack this up a little bit more. Yeah, toughen that bitch up. Haha. It's like getting inside a tank. And I love it. So yeah, as you can see, it's been a little bit of work. I've taken out some of the floorboards just so I can get in here and put in some steel. Still got some more blocks to go. But I'm only going to go down just a little ways for now. Now, someone had mentioned in the comment section that I'm going to have to be careful about zombies spawning underneath the scaffolding, I guess you can call it, out there in the water there. Since the floor's got columns holding it up on top of another floor with columns holding that up, it is possible that zombies could spawn in the water underneath it all. In that case, I'm pretty much boned. Pretty much. Not totally, just pretty much. Let's see. Wow, that used up all my steel. That was pretty messed up. Anywho, just gonna play it careful. Well, kind of in a wait and see kind of attitude about it, really. Let's get these frames here back in. Now it's day 34, soon to be day 35, and we'll have Le Horde coming in. And I'm kind of debating on whether, I'm thinking of just give this base a shot. Let this place take the brunt of it. See what happens. Proof of concept, right? Yeah. Good times. Trying to think of what to do next here. Yeah. And now I've got myself well and thoroughly stuck in here. Probably should have dropped this hatch down a little lower. Well, the idea is that there won't be the need of a hatch in the roof because I'll have a tunnel dug. And I'm hearing something out there. Could just be the game music or something. And why can't I get up through here? I hate this kind of crap. Should be able to hop up here. Should. But can't. That's peculiar. Now I can. So yeah, I really wish Mad Mole and Company would do something about that. Alright, so... All decked out and no place to go. I think what we'll do is we'll head back to the base and we'll make a run for some potassium nitrate because I'm not liking the level of ammo that I have from the sniper. As you can see, it's 114 rounds total. I'm also going to probably do a large chunk of it off camera, but I'm going to want to get some of my supplies from the church brought over. And I'm freezing. I want to bring that stuff over so that I'll have it when I need it. And end up using the church as a fallback position. Hopefully. Hopefully I won't need to, but, you know. Alright, so while I've been gone, I've been making steel like crazy. Like insano. And that's what amounts to crazy these days. Alright, so let's ditch off some of our excess goods. I'm gonna put these up in here too. Well, you know, I'm gonna take them with those and, I don't have a partial stack of wood. I'll take some wood with me, too, just to be on the safe side. Water can stay. Just scooch these over. And... yeah. So at this stage of the game, you know, the zombies are going to be just insane. Tough to kill. And, we need as much ammo as we... get off at you. We need as much ammo as possible to thoroughly deal with them. So... okay, so the marker is still good on it. Whee! Crap. Get out of there. Oh, come on. I missed the turn. This thing turns like a semi-truck. I mean, it's... now I'm doing the awesome powers thing. Come on, you. There we go. Yeesh. So my marker is off this away. Waking up the neighbors. Sucks to be them. But then again, they're dead, so it's... yeah, it still sucks to be them. Follow the brown non-brick road. Hello. Seriously, dude, you need... regulate your core temperature a lot better. Much gooder. Tree. Hi, Pooch. Oh, no, you didn't. Hey, bear. Yeah, help me out with that zombie problem there. Should be getting there pretty quickly here. Doink. I think it might be just over this hill. Alright, Dukes of Hazzard style. Yeehaw! No Dukes of Hazzard style, what the hell? Hello. So yeah, we really need to get some more, mainly potassium nitrate, because I got a lot of coal. Just not a lot of potassium nitrate. Whoa, don't want to go down in there. So I'm going to go down in there. Against my will, apparently. I just went up. Oh, shit. Whoa! Damn it. Dogs. Why does it always have to be dogs? Oh, jeez. Roadkill McPoochins over there. And a bike that just can't turn. Oh shit. Knock it off, Poochins. Alright, boys. Damn, I'm infected and bleeding. What a day this has turned out to be, huh? What, are you mad because I sicked a bear on your friends? Ah, give me a frickin' break, will ya? And you must be dead on your feet. Yeah. In the throat. Thanks for the soup. Ah. Damn it. I picked up her sandwich. Alright, now that we're all mangled up and nasty, let's lock it down. Set up a secondary block here. And time to start picking our nose. I mean, picking some potassium. And let's see, where did I put those stairs down? Here we go. Alrighty. So we got some resources here, but they say it's cold, but it's not coal. There it is. There we are. See, I'm going to have a lot of digging in my future here, because I got to dig the tunnel underneath the new lake base. That's going to be a lot of digging. Not particularly looking forward to it, but it's a cursed necessity. Not so worried about coal, to be honest with you. just seeing if I could put a block underneath these pillars here. Try to help support the upper structure. I don't recall the numbers for potassium nitrate and coal to make gunpowder, but I need as much as I can gather. And that's pretty much the number I'm going for, is infinity. A Googleplex. Excuse me. Not bad so far. Actually, we'll put this stuff. Try to sort it out a little bit, or stack it in a sorted way, I guess. Okay. Come on, I need more. Give me more, give me more, give me more. See, and this is why I make the scaffolding, to avoid shit like this, because one wrong hit in the wrong spot will be the right way to kill yourself, or really get a hurt going on, like that. And the purpose of the scaffolding is to help prevent that, or at the very least, alleviate the damage by, you know, keeping you close enough to it that it doesn't have far to fall, and it doesn't have time to pick up the speed to really drill you one. Now, I'm not saying that's the actual way that it works, but if game physics is to be believed, it should be like that anyway. So yeah, we got all this gravel here. And usually behind gravel is a bunch of resources. Like so. Come on, baby. Yeah, I'm like totally in the zone right now. Or my brain's falling asleep. One or the other. Sharky will tell ya. I'd be using the scaffolding and all that now, but again, it's just being pressed for time. Of course, then again, if I die, I'd be even more pressed for time. Come on, There we go. Whoop. Huh. I'm really digging a grave for myself now. No pun intended. If that was even punnable. Alright, let's get back. Ooh. My ambitions for ores overrides my common sense. I'm all over the place up in there. I at least want one full stack, I guess, of potassium nitrate before I kind of call it a successful run. And it looks like that's exactly what I got. So while we're doing that, okay, so 1,000. Well, actually, be more than that, I guess. Let's see, how much is it? 2 and 2 to make 1. That's kind of unfortunate. At least I was able to make 600. Well, I haven't made it completely yet, but, you know, get 600 going. That should be about 200 rounds for the 762 rounds. Ooh, that could have been dangerous. And this place has been a real gold mine when it comes to resources. I mean, it's just jam-packed and everywhere here. Look at that vein of potassium. Holy Moses. Whoa. Ow. And here comes running time. And this is why I have scaffolding too, is keep... I'm having to dig too high. You know, where you can't reach something. Totally going against what you should be doing. And totally doing what I shouldn't, but I don't care. Makes things interesting right now. Sorta. I mean, it is digging after all. Oh, that luscious white powder. Oh, wait. That ain't the powder that goes up your nose. Comes another 660. Excellent. Now what I'm really hoping for is in the ground underneath the lake base, I'm really hoping that there's some really good veins of stuff there, because I don't want to have to go so far to get the good stuff, you know? But at least this is a known and reliable source of material. So, you know, there's that. I know some people have been struggling to find any resources. And I know how it feels, so... For me, this is just payback for tolerating those games where you just can't find Jack, Dilly, or Squat. Back to where we were. Here we go. Hopefully there's some goodies in here. Okay, we got some sand. That's not really a necessary thing really right now. And I hear zombies outside. I'm gonna try to clear this area out a little bit more. Stuck on something here. Let's see. There we go. Much better. And I'm gonna have to get back to base at some point and undo the infection that's running rampant through my veins. So I got plenty of gunpowder grinding up now. There's a whole bunch of gravel and a whole lot of resources underneath it, provided I can reach it. There we go. So I'm really looking forward to Alpha 15, seeing the videos that Mad Mole has put up on YouTube and what's to come. Really looking forward to it. My plan is that when it comes out, I'm not going to immediately update. And I'm going to do like I've done in the past several seasons, and I'm going to blow up my base. So, you know, if you like explosions, as I do, that's something to look forward to. And then after that, I'm going to go absolutely crazy on Alpha 15. Although I would advise to people that they may want to wait a week after Alpha 15 comes out. And that's primarily because every time they release, it takes like 1 to 2 weeks to really get all the bugs out of the new release. And it, well, not all the bugs, but the majority of bugs, the bugs that make the game non-functional anymore. Because it's just always been that case. Alpha 14, we're on the 7th sub-update for the game. And there's still a bunch of issues, of course. And it was that way with Alpha 13, 12, 11, etc. They do take a few weeks to really get it going good. And when it does, then, you know, you got a playable game. So if you're really itching to play the game, just be aware that you may have to restart your game at some points. Just because maybe they have to patch it a certain way, that's the case. So don't get overly attached to your initial game in Alpha 15. You know, basically I would say just play it to get some practice, test the features, that kind of thing. Just don't marry yourself to a base and, you know, the goodies that you get, because, well, you know, you never know. Now, they do try to avoid forced restarts. That doesn't necessarily mean they won't call for it. You know what I mean? It's like, damn it, we have to. This bug is this bad, or something like that. So, definitely something to keep in mind, guys, when Alpha 15 comes out. And I'm thinking it'll come out, I mean, it's definitely going to come out sometime this summer. Whether it's the end of July, tomorrow, middle of August, nobody seems to know. Not even Mad Mole. But you never know. It could just blink. Alpha 15 is now out. Like, what? So, yeah. Alright, so I'm seeing I am in 32 minutes. And there's so much potassium. And I'm so far off the beaten path here, it's crazy. Okay, where is my way out? And this is, again, why it's best to do the scaffolding system as opposed to the running around like a chicken with a head cut off. Although it's also fun. I do have to get back to base and get some extra defenses set up. So we're gonna end this here. If I can get out. There we go. Alrighty, well, thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed this, or at least learned something. That I can mine a hell of a lot of potassium in a very short amount of time. Another 500 gunpowder right there. Sweet. Alright, so like, dislike, comment either way. Keep it polite, keep it constructive, as you guys pretty much have been. And you have my eternal appreciation for that. Yay, 10 mil rounds I may never use. So share my videos, subscribe if you haven't already, follow me on Twitter, sweet, at SilverbladeDagg, D-A-G-G, and I do my best to reply back to comments. Sometimes I can't, but I do eventually, especially the cool and polite ones. So anyways, that's it for me. Why are you still watching? Huh? Huh? Until next time, see you later. Twitch.